students, or are you saying more students?
Like students.
Mandate a vaccine for students?
Yes.
Would you like to answer that? Because I will.
Oh.
How about I answer it?
As of right now, no.
We have different views.
Unless we're directed, I mean, that's what I would look at, or what I would be, unless somebody directs us above us to do something like that, then I would, I don't know, I can't speak for everybody here, but I would say.
I don't know that the FDA was the age that they've approved it down to that.
I heard they moved it down.
Yeah, they moved it down, I still think it's.
I think it's five, yeah, that's what I thought.
They're still waiting on approval.
Yeah.
I saw the article.
No, it's not.
Pretty close to being, they said by November that they would have it.
Yeah, it would be tough, but like I said, it just depends on what we're directed. I mean, a lot of those things, we don't, we control.
Correct, yeah. Basically, just kind of, I just wanted to just be aware of things, I guess.
No, it's a good question, especially right now, employees are getting forced on that, a lot of things, so.
Right.
I would say, you talk about employees being forced, the university recently changed their stance, and people are now allowed to sign a letter of declination because they were losing so many clinicians.
And you?
I was told that this morning.
I had me hope. I know a lot of hospitals are trying to do it, and they don't have enough staff.
Yep.
No, they're not.
Thank you, Sandy. Beeler, Eric?
I'm here to discuss the mask mandate, actually. I prepared something I could read, or I can just kind of free talk about it.
I'll give you a few minutes here, what you got, I mean, however you want to do it.
Well, I'll read it.
You're probably knowledgeable enough about it, you can probably.
So, I did this so I wouldn't ramble on. There's no denying that every mask offers some protection, even the simple act of covering your mouth with the hand when you sneeze offers some. A non-fit tested mask for use against viral pathogens is probably almost academic at best, though. Even the most properly fit N95 mask, we can all attest, if you work in dust, lets dust in. There's always infiltrate around the eyes, around the nose, and that's where viruses are primarily spread, is that contact. Every one of us here tonight has touched our face and then touched other things. So mandating kids to try to wear a cloth mask, it's not mitigating anything, probably. They're all the cloth masks are not labeled, not for medical use. If you wouldn't want to trust that mask to protect you from anthrax, then trusting it to curb COVID is irrelevant, because anthrax is like a 1 to 5 micron size, and COVID is 0.005 to 0.3 microns. So if you wouldn't trust that mask to protect you from anthrax, it's not going to do much for you, honestly, for COVID. In the last newsletter that you posted, you talked about 46% of students have been isolated due to the close contact. How much percentage of the school population was that versus how many people were actually positive or sick and out?
Yeah, and that was about 64 kids in elementary. And the thing with that is the positives weren't very many. It was probably like 4. But because CDC says if you're not masked, they send them all home, and you have to go with what they are. I totally understand where you're coming from, because when you're looking at 4 positive versus 64, that's a lot.
It is, and my concern is that, you know, like if you just speak to influenza on the same thing, you know, historically, you know, there's this magic percentage of absenteeism that prompts school closure, and I'm sure it's much higher than 4 out of 63. So, and I understand that you got to kind of go with what CDC says, but I feel like we're missing the opportunity to keep kids in school. And I know, especially for like our daughter Erin that's in preschool, she's mildly autistic. The consistency of coming is really good for her. Wearing a mask is challenging with her. So that creates a lot of problems for something that's probably honestly not beneficial.
And then we also have Charlie, who, when she is listening to somebody talk, she does not hear the words correctly. And so having a mask, it hinders her education.
Yeah, right. I mean, and if you compare COVID to influenza, you're talking, and again, I know that you guys kind of got a you're sort of railroaded into doing certain things, I get that. But I think in the opportunity where you can pick and choose of mandating masks or what that policy is, I don't think there's a benefit in mandating a mask in something that has a parallel, what appears to be a parallel infection rate, death rate, you know, hospitalization rate compared to influenza. I mean, I will say I don't think that COVID is being reported accurately, because most of you know that I've worked in healthcare a long, long time. And for the 2019 and 2021 flu season, there was 113,000 flu cases, and last flu season there was 1,800. You know, where do all those cases go? We're supplanting one thing for another and making it out to be this horrible disease, which people that have it in the worst mode, it is a horrible disease, no question. Very much like cancer, coronary artery disease, all those things. But we're talking about something that, according to the CDC, has about a, currently in Missouri, about a 1.5% death rate. And we're trying to force masks onto these kids that don't understand compliance. They're still touching their faces. All of us here tonight, like I say, we have touched faces, we've touched other things. I just don't see how a mask mandate is beneficial in this school. In the last 14 days, there's been an 18% decrease in new positive cases in Missouri and a 42% decrease in Saline County, and that's from Department of Health and Senior Services. I mean, so the infection rate is still going down. It's going to go down, and it's going to come back up, because just like the flu, it's going to mutate. It just is what it is. You know, according to them, it's a rough infection rate of about 5%, you know, based on test rate versus positive and negatives. So I think we're generally, you know, what people may grumble, may not always completely agree with decisions that come out, but understand that you have to shoot for the broader good. I don't think that a mask mandate is the broader good here. We're succumbing to fear in something that realistically is not likely to permanently impact these kids. I mean, I got two kids in school. I don't want to get sick. I don't want anybody's kids to get sick. I don't want you guys to get sick, right? I mean, that's what nobody wants. But the reality is people are going to get sick, and it's not going to matter if they have a mask on or not. I mean, I can tell you from personal experience that no matter what's getting reported on the news, there's an awful lot of really sick people that have been vaccinated. You know, there's an awful lot of sick people that haven't been vaccinated. You know, I think it bears being cautious of trying to mandate masks for people that aren't vaccinated, and then saying, well, if you are vaccinated, you don't have to wear it. Because then you're going to start almost something akin to segregation at some point, because then you're dividing a line, right? You're picking a side. And I think that's detrimental to the kids a lot. There's already enough things that you guys have to combat to keep them not from running down the halls with swords and knives. As it is, I mean, honestly, I know how my kids work. They're a handful. So I think what I would say is that masking is not as beneficial as everybody would like you to believe. I've not seen it be that effective. Now, I did recently leave the university for another job opportunity, but I can tell you that the only time down there in an ambulance that anybody wore anything other than a surgical mask was a fresh COVID positive patient that was extremely sick. Other than that, they just wear that, because the understanding is, if you're going to get it, you're going to get it. And the only way to not get it is to wear the enclosed respirator that we kept in the trucks. So outside of those ultimately very high acuity sick patients that were intubated on a ventilator, that were aerosol, you know, creating aerosol coming out of the vent, that's the only time people wore a respirator. You know, so if healthcare places are starting to say, okay, we're going to let you sign a letter of declination for vaccination, we've relaxed this ideology of everybody gets full face shield for every little thing. I don't think it's a realistic expectation to have preschool through 6th, 7th grade that isn't going to comply, try to have a mask mandate. And I know that you're going to have positive cases, and you're going to end up having to send them home. I know you got no choice, but I think you're going to have those positive cases either way. decision that should come from home of, if you wanna vaccinate him, good. If you want him to wear a mask, good. If you don't, we got it, we understand, you know.
Greg, can you kind of just touch a little bit based on what the school law and the conference you went to and what the lawyers are recommending for districts as far as following the health department's mandates?
Yeah, and that's really where we're stuck, Eric. I understand your point completely. I get that. We're kind of stuck between a rock and a hard place. If we don't mask, the health department's going to quarantine. We'll have 60, you know, we'll have kids out more, and we all know that they're not sitting at home. They're out running around.
Well, that's the thing, even if they, yeah, I mean, that's the other thing, is that nobody's staying at home.
Correct. I did ask that of our lawyers. I went to a meeting last week, and I just said, hey, what if we just do our thing? What if we just don't do what the health department tells us? And they told us that when we are notified, that is our notice. I'm reading because I took notes that day, and I brought them because I was, you know, wanted to make sure. We are to follow the health office to ward off any legal actions against the school. If we have been given notice and didn't act on it, we are setting ourselves up to be sued. Because music, our insurance company, will not cover actions of recklessness. And that's what they, and so I was like, oh my goodness, and I wrote it down so that I did not forget that.
So I got this sued by who?
So what if the health department is still saying kids need to be masked, but the attorney general wins his case? What are we gonna do when, you know, health department's saying you have to have your kids masked, and the attorney general's saying if you continue masking your kids, your school district will be sued?
Yeah.
Well, I think the health department follows CDC guidelines, and even right now, even the cloth mask has been scientifically proven to ward off 50% of particles. Now, a N95, the 95 means 95%, but I mean, I think, I don't know, if for every person in here, there's gonna be somebody that has a different opinion. You may be one person, one family here, but we may have 10 others wanting their kids a mask. You know, so I mean, everybody has their own opinions with that, but I mean, myself as a board member, and I had COVID, and I was in the hospital with COVID, like, I mean, I don't know. To me, I'd rather have people in my classroom 50% protected than 0%. I work in healthcare. I've been in healthcare for 24 years. I wear an N95 and a shield all day long. And that's what we're required to do. I work in skilled nursing. We're required to do that based on county numbers. And I think that's the thing with a lot of school districts and a lot of different places. Everything is based on the county. We're all mandated by the county. So
we can sit here and debate. I mean,
yeah.
Right.
Excellent points, really. And I agree with a lot of them. Jamie has points. I mean, we can sit here and debate it all night long. You know, it's unfortunately, we're going to deal with this every month through this school year, we know for sure. You know, I can't tell you where it's going to go because I can't speak for everybody.
Right.
But I'm glad you came. I'm glad you said what you said. You had some good stuff there that you know, is very beneficial. We appreciate you coming. Anytime, give us a call. Give Debbie a call. We like for people to come. We like people to ask. We like people to do this right here and speak, have your facts and everything. That's fine. There's nothing wrong with that at all. But like you said, it is what it is. We're kind of, our hands are tied somewhat.
So the decision to have a mask mandate wasn't yours. Is that what you're saying?
Well, now, yes and no.
I think our hands were forced.
Yes.
To be quite honest, I mean, I can tell you this board is split on
yeah.
mask.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
That's the truth. Now, if we're forced to say, if my kid's gonna be in class and we have to eat taking a mask, then okay.
I agree with that.
We can't
basically
have
that's what
kids
came into.
Or
term of quarantine actually what?
Yeah, it's the quarantine thing that shut down the throat.
And you know, I agree with every single word you said, every single one of them. And I'm saying I don't agree with the quarantine of kids because they were in the same classroom. If one kid's 20 feet away, I don't understand why.
Yeah.
But we're still being forced, our hands forced there.
Yeah, we're not.
So if they don't have masks, we have.
We're not quarantining EMS personnel that are in a 6 foot wide box with a positive patient because there wouldn't be anybody left doing that.
Right.
Yeah, it's.
Well, I mean.
That's it. And that's how.
Nobody's getting quarantined from Walmart either, that's walking around right next to each other, sneezing all over and football games and everything else. I mean, it's.
The worst place in the world.
We're just stuck with being forced this.
Yeah, I get it.
Yeah.
And that's what it boiled down to 2 weeks ago was, you know, we were, there was gonna be more people out. We were gonna have to shut down. And it was like, okay, we'll go this route for that. And that's where we are. It could change. I don't know. I'm with Matt. I'm 100% against Matt.
It's a complex thing.
Yes.
I get it.
And it's, everybody has an opinion.
But like Debbie said, if there's a lawsuit, I mean, obviously, but we, God forbid, that, you know, a kid gets sick and a parent comes and sues us for not having that mask mandate because CDC recommends it, then we're.
Which is completely asinine. We all know that, but it's reality.
But hasn't CDC said that even vaccinated people wear masks?
What's that?
Hasn't CDC said that even vaccinated people wear masks?
But the health department hasn't said.
Once again, we go back to the health department's kind of governs us. Like, we have to go with what they tell us. And they've told us that if you are vaccinated, it's not the best, but you could go without. So I think I'm a broken record. I say we're going with the health department.
Right.
Because I just, you know,
I just have, like,
it is such a hard, it's just a hard spot.
Right.
I see both sides and I'm sitting there going, I've said I don't know a million times. I just need to, and so I just stay with what the health department tells me. And that's where we've been at. And I'm sorry that.
Well, you don't have to apologize.
Well, I mean, I understand where you guys are coming from.
Yeah.
Especially the little ones, you know, so obviously all three of you have little ones. I have little ones. That, it's difficult. You know, I know kids aren't gonna.
Yeah.
Hey, try my mask, you know.
Yeah.
I know.
I mean, Neil, he's in football practice, so.
Yeah.
No one is wearing a mask in football practice, so it's just, and I just looked at it like.
But football practice isn't governed by.
Right. You're exactly.
Or we don't, they don't have anything holding over their head saying, you will get sued.
Right.
You know, so that's what we're stuck.
Yeah, no, you definitely don't want that. I feel like all of us have the number one goal of keeping those kids in school. And I think where in that newsletter did go out, I was kind of like, just because I have, and granted, this is all news, you don't know what is right or wrong, but they're like, you know, even, I agree with the segregation thing. Like, I felt like in that thing, that's how it was. Like, well, if you're vaccinated, you don't have to wear a mask. But if you are, so then Neil comes home and he's like, well, why does so-and-so not wear a mask? And I'm like, well, you know, he got this. And I don't necessarily agree just because I know vaccinated people can get it and spread it.
I agree.
So
agree.
I feel like if you're really going to mask up, then everyone should have to mask up in that sense.
Well, I mean, there's medical reasons for some not.
Well, yes, yes, and I understand that. But if you don't have a medical reason.
I will tell you, Sandy, that going through the hallway, and I know Jess, she's in here.
Yeah.
Most everybody is masked here. When we're walking the hallways, even the ones like, I'm vaccinated, but when I'm walking around the hallways, I put mine out. I almost feel like, you know, what's good for one is good for the other, and I'm going to be the team player with that. So if we all have to mask, we'll mask. And most everyone in here is doing that. There are a couple, like I said, there's some exceptions because of medical reasons, but truthfully, on the big broad,
right.
Pretty much all just doing it.
And I don't envy any decisions you guys have to make, and I'm not here to be like that. I just want to keep the kids in school.
Right. I applaud everybody that wants to do the thing for not themselves but everybody else, but you also have to be careful of pressing that reduction of personal autonomy, right? Because you see it on Facebook, you see it on Twitter, you see it in Instagram of this division of unvaccinated people don't deserve care, vaccinated people are this. And it's like, no, none of that is accurate, you know? But it's this loss of personal choice that it's risky, you know? And I understand that. I'm not trying to drag you guys across the carpet or nothing like that. I know that you're hung by state and federal funding. You're hung by a million things. But just that if you
have the opportunity to, I think, I feel comfortable that you guys would consider other options.
Well, I think as soon as, if anything changes, I mean, we will definitely address it. Every, like, I mean, Deb said, every month, it's gonna be a discussion.
Sure, well, in the next year.
But I do, I mean, I appreciate you coming in and not screaming, you know, cause I know, I've seen other video of school board meetings that haven't gone so well. So I do appreciate that, I really do, get that on the paper. Slater was very calm with our meeting.
You had a lot of good points, Eric, as you always do, and I've known you for a long time, appreciate you coming in and being yourself. For me, I don't want my kid wearing a mask either, but I want my kid to get an education.
Right.
So I, this panel of people here took the steps that had to be taken, in my opinion, to make sure all of our kids are in school, cause that is what this panel's for.
Right.
We have to give everybody's kid in this district an education, that's what we're here for.
Yep.
And it's not easy, it's, every one of us that signed up here, we've all been here a long time, or a pretty long time, minus Bonita. Anyway, and none of us signed up for this, and we're learning very slowly at a fast rate, and, but, that's how I feel about it.
And you're shooting at a moving target.
Absolutely, but we have to give these kids an education, so we have chose what we've chose because of that, in my opinion, or I have, anyway.
Right, well, I mean, I get it, and that's why I was asking, where did the mandate come from? You know, was it just simply a, we're gonna do it because it's Thursday, was there county guidance of you should do this to, or not, you know, if you don't, you gotta kick them out? So, because I agree, the important thing is to, I think as educators in here, everybody knows butts in seats, you know, is what they gotta have.
It's a nightmare when they're not.
Right, cause you guys got to make up all that ground, you know.
Yeah.
Yes, I did.
That's all.
Thank you all for coming, I appreciate you coming, Sandy.